My name is Jamie Anderson. I'm a partner with Rational Acoustics, and I've been the product manager of Smaart since 1999. We formed Rational Acoustics in 2008, and with that, we undertook a complete reboot of Smaart's code base. Now, 6 years later, after its release, with version 7 operationally mature, it's time for our next major development cycle. It's time for version 8.
One of the primary goals with version 8 was to give people a tool that can adapt for any situation that they're involved in, something that can be as simple as they need it to be or as advanced as they expect it to be, and something that is easy to configure any point in between.
One of the first things we did for Smaart 8 is take a look at not only the code base, but the development tools that we use to create it. One of the tools that we use heavily is a C++ framework called Juice. By updating that, we gained support for high-definition displays. So you'll notice that Smaart V8 looks crisp and clean on, for example, an Apple Retina display or any other high-definition display.
With all this added capability came complexity, and so we took this opportunity to look at ways of streamlining the configuration process, with particular eye towards supporting both the premeditated and the build-as-you-go workflows for creating our measurement configs. Any place where we found tasks that were tedious and repetitive in the configuration process, we tried to automate those.
We found during Smaart DI development that many users really liked hide show the data bar feature. We took this concept a step further in version 8 and applied it to all interface control elements.
So we took the data bar and we actually split it into two distinct areas, the plot legend, which lives in the upper portion of the data bar, and the data library, which lives in the lower portion. What this does is gives you easy access to all of your data while at the same time reducing the footprint on system resources and only really using what we need to.
We've also noticed the increased use of Smaart on tablet style and touchscreen computers, computers without a readily available keyboard. This really complicates the use of our hotkey commands. So we created a thing called the command bar, and the command bar is user configurable. It's got 10 buttons, big fat buttons, so that you can activate them with your fingers or whatever you're using as your stylus. And you can configure whatever buttons you want to have.
Something that we've really wanted with version 8 was to expand our SPL, LEQ, and input monitoring capability. Previously, you could only look at one input at a time. Now we've expanded this by adding a broadband meter view with version 8. What it enables you to do is to look at any number of inputs simultaneously, have them calibrated for SPL, log LEQ, all in one window that can be resized and scaled and put in any monitor that you have connected to your Smaart system.
In Smaart 8, we're actually taking advantage of our own API, and we're allowing you to remote control any other copy of Smaart V8 from another copy.
So that's version 8, at least to begin. We've broken out of the single window, fixed GUI environment to allow users to be able to adapt Smaart more closely to their applications. And this is just the beginning. We built Smaart 8 so that we can build Smaart 8.1, 8.2, 8.3. It's just beginning.